Myself Mithali Jain, today I am here you to demonstrate the experiment of study of frequency of energy transfer as a function of coupling strength using coupled oscillator. Order code is 55741. Today I am here you to explain you about the elliptical motion through light spot.
Apparatus required for this experiment are digital stop clock, which consists of reset button and start stop button by means of toggle switch. It shows time in seconds. Two compound pendulum, each of these are essentially an aluminium rod of size 870 mm supported by two pivot arrangement on aluminium stand. Coupling thread with various coupling loads of brass having one hanger of 10 gram and slotted weight of 10 gram, 20 gram and 50 gram hanging on this hanger. Double convex lens, filament bulb on adjustable stand, brass pin, brass weight of 2.5 into 1.5 and brass weight of 1.5 into 1. And graph paper with adjustable stand. This experimental setup consists of two rigid pendulum 1 and 2, and at the upper end of this pendulum a loose thread is hung with the coupling load, and at the lower end of this pendulum a convex lens is hung. First of all, we will switch on this filament bulb and make the setup in such a manner that a spot of light passes through a double convex lens, and we will observe a light spot on the graph paper. Initially, displace the pendulum B and see the spot of light on the graph paper and start the digital clock. Now, switch on the filament bulb and you will observe the spot of light on the origin. For 50 gram of load, displace the pendulum second and start the digital clock. As you can see the elliptical motion in the graph paper, it shows that OX component is losing and OY component is gaining. It shows that pendulum second loses all the energy to pendulum one. And for 50 gram of load, time is 60.3 seconds. Similarly, you can take 2 and 3 readings, which is T1, T2, T3, T4, and take the mean time of oscillations. So, the observation table for the study of variation of split frequency with the coupling mass is follows as: for the coupling mass of 50 gram, T1 is 60.3, T2 is 62.7 and T3 is 60.2. So the mean TE is 62. For 20 grams, T1 is 70.1, T2 is 73.2 and T3 is 70.12. So mean time is 73. For 10 grams, T1 is 80.8, T2 is 79.2 and T3 is 81. So mean time is 81.2. So by reversing the time, you can get the frequency VE. So the graph shown in figure 4 shows that graph between VE and coupling masses. Mode 1 refers to the pendulum second and mode 2 refers to the pendulum first. Now in the another experiment, we will study the energy variation with the number of oscillations. So for that, displace the pendulum second, start the digital clock and count the number of oscillation with the help of a spot of light. And count the oscillations. For 30 oscillations, time is 39.2, which is along OX axis. Similarly, we will find the time for OY axis also. So, for 50 gram of coupling mass, number of oscillations are 30. A0, time period along X axis. Time period B0, time period along Y axis. So for 30 oscillation, A0 is 39.2, B0 is 37. In similar manner, you can calculate a naught plus b naught, a naught square, b naught square, a naught square plus b naught square. After that, you have to plot a graph between number of oscillation a naught square and n and b naught square on the same graph paper, which is shown as. Hence, this graph shows the energy variation with the number of oscillations. Hence, we have studied the frequency of energy transfer as a function of coupling strength using coupling oscillators. So, for further query, you can use the user manual and contact to Tisker Technologies Private Limited, Jaipur. Thank you. Hope you liked the video.